2021 was a great year for astronomy enthusiasts. We witnessed four supermoons, the longest partial lunar eclipse of this century, and the triple conjunction of Mercury, Jupiter, and Saturn. And to top it all, the year ended with the James Webb Telescope launch. So what does 2022 have in store for us? As it turns out, a lot. Here are some of the most exciting things that you will see in the sky this year. Before we continue, make sure to subscribe to our channel. That way you won't miss any of our weekly videos. Early April, a trio of planets. It will be a quiet start to the new year in terms of astronomical happenings, but good things come to those who wait, as three planets will gather in the early morning sky toward the end of March. Mars, Saturn, and Venus will appear extremely close before sunrise during the last 2 weeks of March. The trio will be so close that they will be in the same field of view of some telescopes and binoculars. You can spot all of them with your naked eyes. Although, the rings of Saturn cannot be seen without a telescope. The show will continue after the calendar turns to April, with Mars and Saturn appearing extremely close on April 4th and April 5th, nearly overlapping, while Venus shines nearby. April 21st. Lyrid meteor shower. April is Global Astronomy Month, and folks looking to celebrate the night sky can do so on April 21st, during the peak of the Lyrid meteor shower. This will be the first meteor shower to peak in over 3 months, ending a lengthy meteor shower drought, and producing around 15 shooting stars per hour. The Lyrids will be followed up by the ETA Aquarids less than 2 weeks later, a meteor shower that can offer between 20 and 40 meteors per hour, on the night of May 5. This is also the best meteor shower of the year for the Southern Hemisphere. April 30, Black Moon. The third big astronomical event of the year is the only one that cannot be seen, even with the help of a telescope. The term blue moon has become popularized in recent years, to describe the second full moon in a calendar month, even though the moon does not turn blue in color. The black moon is the counterpart to the blue moon, used to describe the second new moon of the month. New moons cannot be observed, as it is the time when the illuminated side of the moon is facing away from the Earth. Although the black moon cannot be spotted in the sky, this is a good time of the month for stargazing, as there is no natural light pollution from the moon, giving stargazers a darker views of the cosmos. June 14, first supermoon of 2022. There will be three back-to-back supermoons that will decorate the skies this year. Supermoons are rare astronomical events that occur when the moon reaches its full phase, around perigee, the closest point in an elliptical orbit around Earth. As a result, supermoon can appear 14 times larger and 30% brighter than typical full moons. However, the difference in size is barely noticeable with naked eyes. This year we'll get to see three back-to-back super moons on June 14, July 13, and August 12. June 24, planets align in order. In June, you will get to see the alignment of five planets in the dawn sky. Mercury, Venus, Mars, Jupiter, and Saturn are all bright enough to be seen with the naked eye, and they will align in order near the end of June. The rare alignment will appear just before sunrise on June 24 across the eastern sky. The crescent moon will also be in line with the planets, shining between Venus and Mars. Venus will be the brightest of all the planets, followed by Jupiter, Mars, and Saturn. Although the planets will appear to be in a line in the sky, they will not be lined up perfectly in the solar system. This is just how they will appear from the perspective of the Earth. September 26, Jupiter opposition. The first nights of astronomical autumn will bring the perfect opportunity to spot Jupiter in the night sky, as the largest planet in the solar system reaches its opposition. Opposition is an astronomical term, which means that the planet appears opposite of the Sun from the perspective of the Earth. This is the best time of 2022 to see Jupiter, as it is around the point, in its orbit, when it is closest to the Earth, making it appear brighter than any other time of the year. No telescope is required to spot the planet, but it will be an easy and interesting target for people getting familiar with how to use a new telescope. Jupiter is easy to find with a telescope, and the magnification offered by the simplest of telescopes is enough to see the planet's four largest moons, that are Europa, Io, Callisto, and Ganymede. November 11th to 12th, fireballs to flash in the autumn sky. The northern Taurid meteor shower in mid-November is typically a minor meteor shower that often goes unnoticed, but this year might be a year to view the event. Most years, the northern Taurids only produce around 5 meteors per hour, which is way less when compared to the other popular meteor showers. However, the northern Taurids will bring some added intrigue in 2022. The meteor shower, which peaks on the night of November 11th, is known for bringing incredibly bright fireballs that illuminate the entire sky for a few seconds. There seems to be a 7-year periodicity with these fireballs. 2008 and 2015 both produced remarkable fireball activity. December 8th, Mars opposition. One of Earth's closest neighbor, will become a prominent feature in the night sky during the second half of 2022, eventually reaching its peak brightness in early December, as it reaches opposition. The Mars opposition means when the red planet is opposite of the Sun, from the perspective of the Earth. As a result, it will be visible all night and will shine brighter than most stars in the night sky. Mars only reaches opposition once every 26 months. After 2022, it will not happen again until January 2025. These close encounters are also the best opportunities for space agencies like NASA to launch missions to Mars. December 13th, Geminid meteor shower. One of the most anticipated annual meteor showers will also be one of the final astronomy events of the year, when the Geminids peak during the second full week of December. Under ideal conditions, the Geminids can offer over 100 meteors per hour, but the nearly full moon will once again block the shower. A similar thing happened in 2021, when a bright moon reduced the rate of meteors to 40 meteors per hour. The evening could be the best time to view this meteor shower, before the moon rises between 10 to 11 p.m. However, the meteor shower will be active all night, with shooting stars mainly visible in darker areas of the sky, where the moon is out of sight.